Hey guys, my name is Kuyanje and welcome to episode 7 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. This will be another quick episode where we'll be discussing one specific block, which is, in this case, the MEIO port. The MEIO port is a pretty cool block that allows you to transfer contents from your network into separate ME drives and the other way around. So as you can see right here, I got myself a little ME network setup with an ME controller, an ME drive with a 4K storage cell in it, which has a stack of hardened clay in it, the ME terminal of course, and the MEIO port that looks like this. So the interface may be a little bit confusing, but don't worry, it really isn't that difficult. So first of all, there is two slots, or six slots on the left and six slots on the right. These are for the actual storage cells that you either put in here to set the items that are on these cells into your network, or the exact other way around. Then on the right there are upgrade cards, which are purely for acceleration cards most of the time. I don't think there is anything else there. And there is the operation mode, which you can pretty much configure what this block should do when the actual drives are emptied, when you actually, you know, put them in here. So again, like I said, I currently have a drive with a stack of hardened clay in it. So let's say I want to clear out the contents of my drive. All I have to do is set the transfer direction from transfer data to storage cell, as the arrow would also show from this drive to the cell, and also otherwise show the other way around. Then all I have to do is get myself a storage cell. This can be any storage cell that you want. It doesn't matter, the capacity doesn't have to be the same or anything. It will just try to move as many items as possible until the drive that you try to fill is either filled with bytes or the separate types. So let's put the 4K drive in here. As you can see, it emptied the drive right here into this 4K cell. As you can see, this thing is currently empty. The terminal doesn't have access to anything anymore because it technically is empty. And these items are currently stored on the 4K storage cell. Of course, this also works the other way around. Just set it to transfer data to network. Put your 4K storage cell, or any storage cell for that matter, that has items in it on the left. And once it's done, it will move the empty drive to the right, or whatever you specify to do right here. Pretty awesome. And now it should have put it back into this network. Pretty awesome. And you might think, okay, but why is it really useful? Well, like I explained last episode, how the ME cell or the cell workbench works with partitions. What you can do is, for example, when you have an unpartitioned network, let's say you have like this cell is completely maxed out with random junk. What you can do is just take this out, put some partitioned drives in it that can only select, for example, one drive for dirt only and one drive for cobblestone only. As partition drives pretty much have a priority over the normal drives, the MEIO port will try to fill those drives first. So that will pretty much help you clean up your network a little bit for maintenance purpose. Pretty much, instead of having drives that store random junk all over the place, you can specify with the cell workbench what you want the specific drives to only be allowed to have. Put the junk cell into the MEIO port, and the MEIO port will try to put the items that it is allowed to put in here into the specific storage cells. Pretty useful if you ask me, especially for those people with very big ME networks, which I am usually one of those people. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed these shorter videos. I'm hoping to do a couple of these for the blocks that, in my opinion, don't really deserve a full episode, but are definitely worth talking about, just like this one. And yeah, pretty cool. So again, if you have any feedback, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below, like always, and feel free to leave me a rating, which is always, of course, appreciated. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.